Now, sometimes in Suzuki, the kids will choose to play a few songs at one of our little play-ins or big recitals and graduate from the book that way. And sometimes kids do the entire playthrough, and Sarah has opted to do that tonight. So we're so excited, especially I think you will enjoy their story, very whimsical. Those of you that have played Honeybee, you'll have to pay careful attention because we have kind of a little surprise in the middle of that. Also, we have a treat in that Sarah's mom, Julie, is going to read this story for us today, and so you won't have to listen to me. Get to hear somebody much more interesting. Because of the flow of the story, when Sarah takes her bow, and then again at the end, so just you can applaud then. Just hold your applause. Don't applaud in the middle of the story. We'll just let it go along. A little about Sarah. She's a 5-year-old homeschooler. Some of her favorite things are playing with her stuffed animals, teaching her real dog Fufa tricks, riding her bike and hanging out by the Carillion on campus, and everything pinkalicious.
Outside the box. Henry David Thoreau once wrote, "If a man does not keep pace with his companions, perhaps it's because he hears a different drummer. Let him step to the music which he hears, however measured or far away." Once upon a time, there lived a little girl that lived outside a rather large crowded box, right beside a blooming pink crepe myrtle tree, with her mother, father, Fufa the dog, and sparkly pink piano. In addition to spending much of her time playing her beloved piano, she also passed away the hours marching to the beat of her very own drum. This made for some very peculiar alterations to several hit Suzuki songs and several rather interesting discoveries and stories along her musical journey through book one. Her first and perhaps most favorite improvement was in the ever popular Honey Bee. Don't tell the sheriff of Inside the Box, whose name is Aunt Aunt Rhody.
Thank you.
because there was just no spare time left between all of her marching and piano practicing. Therefore, she felt more comfortable referring to Au Clair de la Lune as By the Light of the Moon. Disappears. And so, before we conclude, we must pay tribute to the roots of the Suzuki crepe myrtle tree. If well taken care of, watered, given nourishment, and plenty of room to grow, the tree will someday give all Suzuki students the freedom to thrive well outside of the box for a lifetime. We present, in an outside-of-the-box fashion, of course, the perfectly entitled Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star Variations.